Good evening, everyone. Welcome back to this wonderful platform, SESL, where we are basically doing a lecture every, once in a while and bringing an expert to this wonderful platform. And today we have a very, very esteemed personality amongst us, right? We have Mr. D. Shivanandan, the ex-police commissioner of Mumbai, Thane, Nagpur, the director general of police. And today he's going to speak on a very, very important topic, cybersecurity. Our children are online. They are playing various games. They are visiting chat rooms. They are doing social media. They are visiting various websites. How safe are they? How secure are they? How much data are they sharing? Are they unknowingly giving up too much information, right? As a parent, we are always worried. How safe is my child when he's online? Especially once the lockdown opens, parents start going to their offices and children will be taking online classes sitting at home. What are the things that they'll be doing? So sir is going to guide us today on these important aspects of cyber safety. So over to you, sir. Very welcome to this wonderful platform. Thank you for taking out time for us. All over to you, sir. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much. Thank you. So kind of you. Can we start the PPT? Good evening, Madam Revati Srinivasan and all the other teachers and the dear students and the parents. Welcome to this presentation. I thank Madam for having given me this chance to talk to you. Once again, I've been coming very regularly to the school and delivering some lecture or the other. I'm sure all the children would be wondering as to what it is we are using cyber arena and we are talking about safety. We used to make fun that the children were told not to depend upon the mobiles, not to use the mobile, and not to use the systems. But now the whole school is there inside the mobiles or inside the devices, and we are teaching. The entire curriculum is being taught through the same devices, which are supposed to be prohibited to be used by the children. So we are monitoring them and all that. But how is it now that we are depending upon this? So this is what is a dynamic world all about. This is how the world keeps on changing. Next, please. So we are going to speak in four parts, types of crimes. I'm concentrating only on the type of crimes which the children are exposed, not to the bankers and not to the various others. One or two examples I might give, cyber security and things like that. Next. So now is this presentation. Here is a coronavirus. This is the most dangerous coronavirus you've ever faced in the entire century or in the human history, because all other things were known, but this is an unknown virus. We are very scared that when we are talking to somebody, is he carrying the coronavirus? Is he going to inflict it on me and I on the others? That is how the cyber crime and the cyber criminals are also the same. You don't know who they are. They don't have a face. They are at a far off place and we don't know how they look like that at all, you know. So this is an unknown criminal as good or as bad as the coronavirus from whom we are trying to hide now. Like next. So here, the criminals are always first to adopt new technology. If all of you find time, please go to TEDx and see a presentation of mine called the technology and terrorism, where I've said the terrorists have always been three steps ahead of the others, and they have been adapt new technology, and they have the money, the wherewithal, the mindset and all that, and that is what is we are supposed to have in our developmental arena. Next. So here an example I'm giving you. In 1 minute, in 60 seconds, what's happening in the cyber area? If you see the YouTube, 4.5 million videos are viewed, and Facebook, 1 million logins take place, and 18.1 million texts are sent. In Google, it is 3.8 million search queries happen. In Netflix, 6,94,444 hours are watched in a minute's time, because we are talking of a population of 7 billion people. So is that Instagram and tweeting, all that, if you can see, the furious activities are taking place. Furious means real, mind-boggling kind of activities are taking place. In that kind of a sweep, we can also be swept away and crime can take place against me or you or, for that matter, anybody who is high and mighty. You can see these activities are increasing. They are not coming down at all. Next. So, are we, are you ready to stop them? I'm giving you an example. A hacker, a 10-year-old, a 10th standard boy or a girl, if he or she is sitting down in a basement, they can shut down an entire government. For example, the Aadhaar card, which is 1.2 billion in number, can be hacked. It has been hacked by somebody like you, as intelligent you. So then they can change the health parameters. They can get into that. Pentagon, for that matter, the mighty Department of Defense of the USA, they have been attacked so many times by brilliant minds. They say that anybody who can hack can claim a prize. Means they have surrendered in front of the people who can do this to them. They can, anybody can steal money without going to the crime scene. Like Bangladesh Bank, $83 million have been taken away by criminals sitting in Mauritius. The bank is located in Dhaka and the money was kept in the New York and the money was taken away and delivered at Manila. I'll tell you more about it later. They can control and crash one's most expensive car by devising a system which is less than $100 worth. So they can also rob a bank of billions of dollars in minutes. It takes years, of course, to study, then be there in the system and all that. But when the hack takes place, it is just in minutes. They can shut the power grids. They can make an entire country go dark. They can enter into a nuclear plant, or they can assume the identity of billions of people like the Aadhaar card I mentioned about. They can even murder a person. Yes, my dear children, somebody can be murdered through cyber. A cyber murder is possible. How is it? If the parents of the teachers are going to ask me, I'll say, okay, and somebody is having an insulin pump. If we can remotely control that, if it attached to the body, one can download the entire insulin. If somebody is having the pacemaker in the heart, we can have a remote and make them jump like a butterfly and die. These things will be attributed to malfunctioning of the machines rather than any attempt to murder. Later on, when a postmortem is done, somebody will say that this is a malfunctioning of the machine. That's about it. The killer goes scot-free. This is how cyber murders are possible. They are being done also. Next one. So here, these are the types of crimes. You can go to the next one. We have all these kind of things. Since I'm going to explain each one, we don't waste time on this slide. We can go to the next slide. So here is the mobile recharge shop where in the villages, they go for recharging. In the cities, maybe we are doing it online. Online is becoming where we are in the digital Modi era. Online charge is there. But if in the villages, when these children or young girls go there, they go to a place where they can gain access to their cell phone. And because they have provided to the recharge vendor, they can manipulate the phone in such a way that whatever somebody is doing is being recorded and they can misuse it to call or text or exploit your ignorance or even emotionally manipulate you. This is happening in the villages and in the other areas where we leave our mobile in a mobile recharge shop. So my first advice is never ever part with your device. For example, your desktop or tabletop or the laptop or mobiles and all, never ever leave it open so that others can insert a device or they can leave a virus or they can manipulate it remotely. Next, that is the first crime children should be very, very aware of. Second is debit card cloning. I wonder how many of you have debit cards, but the parents definitely have debit cards. So just by bringing that device, next to you in the airport or in the railway station or anywhere, they can clone a card and then start misusing it and do away with it. For example, in the Cosmos Bank attempt, they took away 94 crores of rupees from all over the world within 3 days. First attempt was 80 crores, and after 3 days, another 14 crore was taken. They used cards, multiple cards they used. They were all cloned cards. So debit card skimming happens when the PIN is revealed to another person. The PIN number is sacred. So is the card and the CVV number. A scamster who knows the PIN and has the possession of the card even for a short while by skimming from the ATM or various other means, they can replicate the card and they can withdraw cash as many times as possible. Sometimes when you are in the country, then in the USA, they use it and take away your money. But you are supposed to report within a short time, 3 days, and the bank is supposed to reimburse. I wanted to tell all of you right from the beginning, none of these cases have been detected by anybody. Most of the times, the money which is lost is reimbursed by the insurance, or the bankers recompensate or deposit your money. But many times, 99.5% of the times, when a cyber crime takes place, the money is not recovered from the criminals. Be careful about that. Next. So if you have a debit card, put it in a sheet, a rubber sheet, and keep it so that nobody can copy that. Keylogger. It is a malicious program that may be installed in the victim's computer for recording the computer's user keystrokes to steal the passwords or other sensitive information. With a keylogger, a scamster will be able to collect login details and other matters saved in the computer and have them mailed to a designated email address. For example, there can be a camera on top of the, say, ATM or anywhere, and they can just check as to what numbers you've been punching. From the temperature of the fingers, our body, they can find out which one was logged first, which number was pressed first, and second, and third, and the... So like that, they can take away the entire number in its sequence and they can use it to steal money from you. This is the keylogger program. Next. There is another program, please. There's another program called Boxy. It gives you a billion options of keywords. Whatever your keywords are, they can have a billion options given in that program. So SMS spoofing. It's a malicious program that may be shopping online has to be done keeping guidelines in mind, or else one can become a victim, or phishing from fake websites and a message spoofing from unscrupulous elements. Any message, if I send a message and somebody opens that, then onwards, that mobile could be in my control. So any email with attachment, if it comes from an unknown person, before opening it, think 10 times. And particularly for the adults, very, very attractive kind of attachments or hooks come, and they are the virus infected ones. Then onwards, our mobile or the instrument can be run completely remotely by the criminals. Next. So call spoofing. Call spoofing happens through apps that enable a person with a criminal intent to change one's number and voice to impersonate another to defraud the receiver. For example, anybody can call a child, a girl, in the voice of her father or voice of somebody, mother or sister or brother, and say something and take them away from a particular scene and criminally do whatever they like. So if you listen to anybody, which is a message which is very, very important, you have to act upon that. Kindly cut the call, later call the concerned person and find out whether they did call and give you an information. I'll give you an example. If the chief minister or the prime minister is going to call me when I was the commissioner of police, they say something to be done, we listen and then disconnect, later give a ring to his office and find out whether he made the call, or even ask him directly, the CM, saying that, sir, did you make a call? Did you say so-and-so thing. If he says yes, and then we believe that the call was made by him and the voice belongs to him. So caller can be different, but the voice can be different, so that you can become easily evicted. Next. So ransomware is happening in Mumbai also. Then here, any malicious person can use a software and freeze your entire data and then perpetually block access to that. And then they ask for money from cryptocurrency, that is the bitcoins, 300 bitcoins or 3000 bitcoins. And it's so expensive. And after having received the money, and then only they release it. If you all think it is happening elsewhere, no. Even in the year 2004 and before or later in Mumbai, there have been cases where. So while I'm speaking on ransomware, I must tell you, there was a CEO who called me and said, somebody is demanding money from me, saying that I visited various sites which are not porn sites. But then he has not done that. Some criminal had the audacity of putting it across into his system, evidence to show that he has visited the porn sites and started demanding money. So that is why my advice is that if something happens to you in this area, please be bold to tell your parents and the people, friends or your teachers, and go to the police and get that person caught rather than be a dumb victim. You can't tell others that I was so scared. No, there is no question of getting scared. You have to take somebody in confidence. Next. So cyber stalking, it happens to the girls mostly. Cyber stalking is the use of internet or other electronic means to stalk. Means go piche piche jana hai, harass karna hai. Or harass another by misusing information uploaded on the social networking sites. Continuous harassment, mental harassment, cyber stalking is that. It is a crime. It is a crime under the Act, IT Act 2000, as well as in the Indian Penal Code. So if somebody is doing it, you have evidence on your phone or on your system, be bold to go there and file a case against them. You are only a victim. In all these cases I am mentioning, dear children, please believe me that you are only a victim and you are not the criminal. So you don't have to worry as to what others will think of me. Don't get harassed by the criminals. Go there. Next. Next one, please. Yeah, picture morphing. Now, this is very important for all the people who are watching this. That we can take anybody's picture and convert it into somebody else's picture. The entire face or entire body or entire clothing or entire anything can be changed. So morphing the face of a person to the body of another and publishing it to blackmail or otherwise intimidate the person is one of the ways by which people who upload photographs on social networking site can be exploited. Specifically speaking, the face could be yours and the body could be somebody's and there can be no clothes. It is shaming you. But then it is completely marked. It may not be your picture at all. One has to be bold not to get blackmailed. Go there to the police and get these people exposed. Even entire presentation, the movement of the mouth, the delivery of a lecture or anything, or even singing a song, can be completely masked by the software skills of a person. So don't get flabbergasted when something happens like this to anybody. And don't believe all the pictures which are coming. So we are so quick in sending all the WhatsApp pictures and this and that when it comes to others. So please check, counter check whether this is a photoshopped picture or altered marked picture or otherwise. Next. So profile hacking. Profile hacking happens when your email or social networking site is accessed by a probable stalker who then compromises that. That is remote control. I hack. It is happening to various CEOs and various others and the bankers and the business community. Profile hacking happens. Even they hack into the email and sit on the system in companies for 264 days before any company realizes. So we'll have to change our email ID, password every now and then and see that it is not hacked by others. For companies and parents, my suggestion is get your machines swept clean by some expert and see that nobody is sitting on your system or no virus is hanging on your system. When you buy antivirus system, see that they are the latest and don't be conjuice on that, spending on this Norton and various other things. See that that is proper. Next one. Online games is very important for the children. Girls who are vulnerable to loneliness, having depression, low self-esteem, and clinical depression can fall prey to dangerous online games that may become addictive and further harm to them. Some, like the notorious Blue Whale Challenge, even in the end, the victim is ending his or her life. Not only girls, boys also. This is a personal as well as a social challenge for others to end. Blue Whale is one, Before You is another game. And like that, the games are continuously being introduced to people so that they can be lured into that and the life gets ended there. Beware of such games. Do not join them. If you join by mistake, kindly let others know so that they can take you away from danger. Next. So job call letter. This is for the elderly people, not for the school children. So offering like TCS and Wipro and Infosys and all that, it looks so genuine. But then all of them are fake ones and they ask for money and they do interview and various other things. Later on, neither the job comes to you nor the money comes to you. So are the other offers. Like suddenly they say Reader's Digest has given you a $2 million reward in a lottery and things like that. No one ever gives you 1 rupee. In a Thane matter, when I was a commissioner, I know a lady teacher had paid 27 lakhs of rupees in installments to the criminals for getting such kind of a money, $2 million. Nobody would ever give you at all. Be careful about such kind of luring offers. Next. So deepfake. Deepfake is a technique that is used to combine and superimpose new images and videos onto the source image or videos. It is used to create videos where the voice or the face of another is superimposed on the original in such a way that the viewer or the listener cannot distinguish or doubt the veracity or the proof of it. So these are deep fakes. Say, let us say Narendra Modi's image or Amit Shah's image or various images, politically, otherwise, or even personally also, somebody can do that and they can float it around. And we are all so gullible and so easy to believe that we start sending it to thousands of people. So I'm again warning you at the cost of repeating, please do not forward such kind of interesting WhatsApp messages or other messages. Check, verify, and then only you can do that. There are means of finding out. There is an app which will find out whether it is a fake or not. Okay, next. The other crime is dating website. In South India, where I belong to, a place called Coimbatore, where a small young girl was lured by people by this dating website. And after developing little friendship, she went there to meet. And there was a group rape happened. And they put the video on the viral internet system. So that is how the girl went out and committed suicide later. Later, I was asked to go there and deliver lectures to about 25,000 children in 5 days. I went to different schools and delivered lecture, and this is what happens. So when this kind of websites come, you come across them, check. There will be somebody who will be masquerading as man or woman or USA or UK and all that. Everything can be fake about it. The whole idea is to take away money or trap you in a way that you cannot escape from the consequences. So be careful about such kind of unscrupulous persons giving you, offering various other things like dating websites. Next. Camera hacking. This camera is inside your computer, laptop, on top, in the middle, there is an aperture, and that can be activated by anybody from outside by sending a message. And after that, whatever is happening inside the house or office or anywhere, you are there in a mood to be not very careful. Those pictures or videos can be taken away, and later they can blackmail. So you have to guard it by covering the aperture, and you have to check the malware, and all that kind of precautions you have to take. Next one. Social trolling. There are hundreds of people who are employed by people for trolling innocent people who show their thumbs up very easily or thumbs down easily. What is social trolling? Is posting inflammatory messages or visuals about a person or organization in an online community with the express purpose of causing humiliation or nuisance to the object of trolling. It can happen to the Congress I, Rahul Gandhi, or it can happen to the BJP. So these are all groups of people. It can happen to you and me. I want you to remember a young girl in Thane, Vasai Virar. She said something. She showed the thumbs up, and they were trolling, and they went to the house. They threatened. They got them vacated from the house. So much happened. The Supreme Court later intervened, and Section 66-67 was removed, and arrest was prohibited under that section. But then you suffered. The girl suffered. Next. Cyberbullying. This happens to the children of your age. Cyberbullying is the use of technology to harass, threaten, embarrass, or target another person. Online threats and very mean, aggressive, or rude texts, tweets, posts, or messages, all of them count under cyberbullying. If you are a victim, be bold. Go to the police station, register a case. It is a special crime. Particularly, children should not be suffering mentally or otherwise. Be careful about that. Next. This is a deadly blue whale game I mentioned about. This has become old now, that before you is the next one. So any such game, be careful about that. This is a 50-day based game, a dare based game. And by the end of it, either you kill somebody or you commit suicide. Beware of this. Take the parents in confidence. Next. What is cybersecurity? Next one. Here, this one, I am showing it to you from yesterday's Times of India. Sexual harassment goes online and complaints are pouring in. Particularly during this coronavirus lockdown time, 5,000% is the increase in such crimes. So despite employees working remotely, there have been a number of cases under POSH, that is Prevention of Sexual Harassment Women at Workplace Act. In the same way, there is another against the children also, Prevention of Sexual Harassment Against Children. Under these acts, there are so many thousand cases which are going on. So be careful about that, because an empty mind is a devil's workshop. Next one. Next one. So here are examples. Vladimir Putin personally offered influence campaign to lower Hillary's credibility, and he helped our friend Donald Trump to get elected. This was investigated by Rob Mueller, ex-FBI director, and he came to a conclusion that the president of USA cannot be prosecuted. That is how it is. Next one. I'm giving you an example as to high and mighty have fallen victim to such kind of thing. In the same election campaign, a hacker by the name of Gusifier 2.0 hacked into the Democratic Party computers, pulled out thousands of emails which Hillary Clinton had sent or received. She did not use the official handle. She used a Gmail account, which is absolutely not done for the Secretary of State of the USA. But then the hackers can pull out and defame her, and she was not elected because of this and for various other reasons. Next. Here is Erdogan, your president of Turkey. About 3 lakh internet emails were hacked and put it in the open, and he was taken to task by the hacker by having access to all that. So this is how mighty people are vulnerable to hacking. So you have to be very, very careful. That's why I'm showing you these three examples. Next. So here is our own India, where this is Jamtara. There is a web series going on in Netflix. These people are from this village in Jharkhand. Their daily job is to buy SIM cards in bulk, go there under the tree, sit and talk to you as the branch manager of a bank and defraud you from the bank in your account. They take away the money daily. Police have not been able to go there and penetrate and catch them because of various reasons. And this is happening in India continuously even now. Next. So here is the original version. This is a village in Romania where a lack of residents stay. Look at their houses. Look at the posh cars they have. What is their job? The full-time job is hacking, crime, cyber crime, and they indulge in spending like this because their money, which they are earning by this kind of a crime, is quite very impressive. Next. So here is the example which I gave you earlier. You have to be careful about your bank accounts or your money, e-wallet, and various others. I'm giving this only as an example to highlight what I have been telling you, that even though the website or the account is protected by brilliant IT officers, they spend thousands of crores and things like that, but still somebody can sit. In this case, the Nigerians are so, we believe so, they were sitting in the system for 2.5 years checking their dealings, and one fine Friday evening, they ordered the Bangladesh bank account kept in the Federal Reserve of New York, USA, to release money in the name of people there in Manila, and $1 billion was ordered to be released. By the end of the deal, by Monday morning in Manila, they did get $83 million. And since then, it is 4 years now, my dear young friends, 4 years now, it has not been detected either by FBI or by Scotland Yard or by anybody. This is the capital with which they can invest and have better hardware, software, and do more and more crimes. Many banks have lost money and they have not been able to detect it. So this is what I've been telling you. Compensation can come from insurance, but definitely you cannot arrest the criminals and recover the money. This is one example you should remember. Next. So this is that spying called Suckfly. So this affected the whole world, and then many Equifax, so many other companies, so many things have been hacked continuously in the last few years. Millions and billions of dollars lost by various corporates, but there is no solution. Next. This is example of cyber spying. This is a cryptocurrency. The other day, one young boy came and asked me whether he can start a cryptocurrency exchange. I said, it is neither legal nor illegal. This cryptocurrency, like Bitcoin, Let's Pay, and all that, is neither legal nor illegal. So in this space, you may be in danger all the time. That's what the advice I gave. So here, Tokyo-based cryptocurrency exchange called Coincheck was hacked. $532 million was stolen by the hackers in one swoop or sweep, whatever you say. Details of the hack are still very, very unclear. So you are in the danger zone. Next. This is Yahoo. I'm showing you as an example. So many others have been hacked. Clubs have been hacked. Banks have been hacked. So many accounts have been hacked. I'm giving you 500 million accounts have been hacked at Yahoo. And the company is already facing 3 class action lawsuits in the USA. It could jeopardize the recent sale of Verizon and various other economic activities. So the point is very simple, that if you have a Yahoo account and if it has been hacked, 500 million accounts, whatever transactions you have done could be compromised. You could be exposed. And then what happens to you, your business, to your reputation and all that. So when you use such emails and all that, you have to be very, very careful as to what are you transacting and what you are up to. Next one. What is the solution? Next. These are the advice I have to give you. Having brought you to this level, I will say one, stay safe, be smart. Do not give out your personal information to the people or the others whom you don't know. Any personal information like bank, card, CVV, your address, mobile number, identity, so many things they ask, please do not give it to those people who are unknown to you. Second, do not go and meet someone you have only been in touch with the online. That can be very, very dangerous. It can be a man, woman, animal, white, black. You don't know what it is. Always check with an adult you trust. Take somebody with you. If you are going to meet somebody, then you have to carry someone else with you, so that some adult with you, parents or brother or anybody, so that you don't get into a trap. Third is accepting any email, files, pictures or text from people you don't know can cause enormous problems to you. You don't know that you have been hacked. For years, they can keep waiting and catch you at the wrong foot. Fourth advice is, check information before you believe it. I gave you examples earlier. Somebody's picture with clothes or without clothes or saying something, all that can be completely masked. So is the person or the website telling the truth? Do you have a system by which we can check? Yes, you can check and you can verify. And do not be in a hurry to pass on such information to others. You can be prosecuted for rumor mongering, or you can be prosecuted for various other consequences. Five, tell someone, if you are into some difficulty or the other, do not suffer, do not fall a victim, and you don't feel guilty about it. You're only a victim. So tell an adult, your parents or your teacher or a counselor or somebody, so that you can take recourse to the law. Go to the police station and get a case registered. Next. So how to be cyber safe, or how to be safe in the cyber arena? Due to poverty and rise in the unemployment now, that COVID-19 issue, there will be a lot of increase in online frauds because people don't have money. I gave you an example of Jamtara, an underdeveloped village in Jharkhand state. So beware of your credit card and banking details. If the parents are listening to this, beware of your jewelry also. Immediately, chain snatching will yield a lot of returns for people who are suffering from poverty. So be very careful about how much money you carry and what kind of jewelry you wear, or leave it in the house and things like that. This is a stage where people are suffering from extreme poverty. So beware of that and be careful about it. So keep your social media accounts private. I want to tell all the children who are listening that whenever you upgrade your technology or the system, your settings relating to privacy, they get neutralized. You have to go on checking every day, like you do prayer in the morning, evening and all that. See your privacy. Whoever is authorized should only have access to your phones or the accounts, not everybody else. It will thrown open to others. So be careful about your privacy setting. Do not disclose personal details on the public domain. I know a school child, a daughter of a friend of mine, she had put all sorts of pictures in the beach and this and that and all that, and she became a victim. They came to me, I was in the service, and we could sort it out in the typical police way. But then, if you are very scared and if you are worried and you worry about your social reputation and things like that, you can fall a victim very easily. Keep your password strong and secret. Not less than 12 digits should be your password, with numbers and symbols and various other. Make it a secret combination of 12 digits, and then change it once in a way, and do not give it to anybody else, friend or enemy. You never part with your password. That's the danger. Do not allow others to access your electronic gadgets. When you leave and go in a public place, do not leave your systems open. Always shut down and then go, so that others do not creep into your system and start doing things which are funny. Next one. So do not discuss your tour programs openly. Oh, my family, we are going to Japan or Switzerland for 1 week and all that. That time somebody can come, program in such a way that they can take away, rob the house and do a thing or anything else. I'm giving only an example Many things are possible in this area. So do not visit any website. This is the most important thing I wanted to tell students who are in 12th, 11th, 10th, 9th and all that. There are a lot of attractive sites which are dark web area, and you think that you have visited and nobody else knows. Please beware of this, that people are watching you, profiling you, wherever you visit, whatever you did, that is permanently on record, and that act can be attributed to you. So innocently going and doing something and then expecting that nobody will know what you visited or what you did or what you saw, if you think that you are naive, N-A-I-V-E, naive and innocent, you can be caught absolutely in the dark web. Be careful about it. There are sites where all things are done. Weapons are sold, like all other things, all kind of things which are wrong and illegal can happen in that area. But what I want is, whatever little thing you do innocently on your mobile or on your systems, they are all tracked. You are leaving in, for example, I buy a particular product, say a perfume or anything else. They know, they are profiling me that I am buying this. They start suggesting, you buy this, you buy that and all that. It is nothing but profiling. Remember, your profiles are being watched by various agencies, either for selling, advertising, marketing, or for even blackmailing. So be careful about that. Allow paternal control on electronic devices. These corona days, parents are there at home, you are at home, you are all very, very disturbed about each other's presence. But then, if parents want to visit the sites which you have visited, they can slyly visit and check all that you have seen. But instead of that, allow parental control so that they are happy, you are happy, and you don't get sucked into a wrong area. Do not get into deadly games. I mean, I gave you an example of that blue whale game and before you and various other things, so many things which keep coming. Life gets ended there. That is what is the dangerous thing about it. And life is very, very important for us. Do not hesitate to approach the cyber police. Please believe me that police are your friends. Your parents are your friends. Your teachers are your friends. Take everybody in confidence. Go there and get it solved. I mentioned earlier, I'm mentioning again, I'm winding up now. You are a victim and you are not the criminal. You become victor. You don't become a victim, is what I'm trying to tell you since 5 o'clock. Next. So this is that broken window theory. If somebody creeps into your system, the whole edifice collapses. Broken window theory. Next. Your computer system I'm talking about. So there is no silver bullet for cyber crime, cyber terrorism, or cyber bullying, or whatever it is that. Governments, organizations, citizens, and students should prepare themselves against these inevitable threats. How do you prepare yourself? This is the way. Next. That is, be aware. Be aware that you are the smartest, but there are others who are much more smarter than you. You have to have resources to buy the anti-virus and various other programs. The government, the police and others should go on continuously upgrading, and you should have a progressive mindset. This is the last slide as far as cyber preparedness is concerned. By end of it, I would like to say, you please believe that you are vulnerable. You have to take precautions. You have to be all the time cautious about your password and various other things. And if you fall victim by any chance, God forbid, it should not happen. If it happens, kindly tell people and take elders in confidence. Go to the next one. With the permission of Madam Principal, Principal Madam, I want to talk about three slides about humanity. Now, I mentioned about coronavirus all the time. There are 400 million Indians instead of the normal 200 million Indians going hungry. And they are all the migrant workers. They are the ones who are being treated with indignity. They are the ones given us the school building and the tallest structures and all that. Now, we started a NGO called Roti Bank India. And we are feeding them daily to the extent of 37,000 people a day. So you have to be aware about your fellow human being. So I'm showing two more slides with the permission of Madam. Next. So here, you can see the policemen are all delivering food and various other people are all partnering with us. The last extreme right on the top is the Tata Cancer Hospital. And these are young, small children, Singhania school children. I know very well the people who are listening to me. They do join a program called Joy of Sharing. I collect 2,000, 3,000 rotis when you come and give it to me. And I match it with other stuff and give it to the poor children. These are the children who are enjoying the meals given to you. So beware of what's happening around. We are using the police so that we can go to the coronavirus area and they can distribute food to the poor, Dharavi and other area people. We are feeding 37,000 people a day. Next. You can contribute, parents particularly can contribute by monetary donation, or they can give rice, dal and other thing, and if other grains. And if people are hungry anywhere, you can call us on 8655-8001, or you can give us excess food if it is there. We'll collect and give it to them. And we can spread. All the children who are listening, they're all adept in this thing. So they can show Instagram or Twitter or feedback. I mean, Facebook and other things where they can help us spreading the good word. Tie up with schools. For example, I have a tie up with your school. Same way, you can help us in joining others and we can spread the food donation campaign. The elders who are listening to me, if they are working in companies, CSR funds can be, that is corporate social responsibility funds can be released so that we can feed those poor 400 million Indians who have been going in 48 degrees of heat to UP, Bihar on foot, on various other means. A lot of people have died also. So we must take care of the fellow human beings. Next one. So this is us, the bank details and the website. I will only say, please visit the website www.rotibankindia.org or rotibankfoundation.org. There is an email also given to us. Please help us to feed the poor. With this, I thank the principal ma'am and all other teachers and the technology enablers for helping me in confirming and telling you something about what is happening, how you have to be aware. Children are our future. The whole country depends upon your growth and our insurance is you. And so you have to be safe and you have to take care of yourself. I wish you very, very best of luck and a bright future. If there are any questions, I'm willing to answer. Thank you so much. Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much, Ivanandan, sir. I must thank you for the presentation, for that awareness that you have brought in. And I must add the sentence about Roti Bank. We are absolutely in sync with you with the Roti Bank project. Every Tuesday and Friday is our day on a class rotation basis. We contribute to the rotis. And I'm very happy and proud to say that my parents make fresh rotis. They are hot when it comes to school and they're rolled and packed beautifully. And I think the beauty is that you dreamt of it. We are able to contribute very small portion, but I'm happy that so many young children are fed. Your passion for education when it came to the Thane Police School and I know the canteen that you started at the Thane Police Headquarters. And all that you do is more out of passion. I can see that very much, even when you spoke today. But I have one question and I'll just ask that one question before Brijesh goes across with the other questions. And my question to you is that wherever we take our children on tours, the minute they see free Wi-Fi in a public place, they start downloading. You know, and they start accessing free Wi-Fi. How safe or unsafe is it?
Ma'am, it is absolutely unsafe. It is absolutely unsafe. Somehow, we must teach our children and learn ourselves that nothing comes free in life. There is no free lunches as they see it. So in any place, when I go to London, to Harrods or any place, immediately we sit there on a bench, the wife is shopping there, and we start looking for a free Wi-Fi. I download it and start looking for this and that and all that. No, we can carry our own device or we can, even the hotels, they are very unsafe Wi-Fi. Even the hotel door opening cards, now we are on cyber safety, those card also, the door with which we open the doors, they are also very, very unsafe. Even the airport, the check-in card has a spot where they can read all your personal details. So even the check-in boarding card, if you throw it away in the dustbin, somebody can check the QR code and take your name, address, mobile and all that. So when you throw it away, don't put it in the dustbin. Or even the hotel room card with which you open the door, and various such kind of things are all having your personal details. And believe me, if I get one thread or one simple line on you, I can build your entire personal life, career, family, children, the whole thing can be brought in. Because we go on the social media, find out your exposure, your family, your children, your various others, where is your people working and things like that. And we can, if there is a chink in the armor, that can be used by anybody. So in my opinion, anything coming free, we should say, no, thank you. That is what we teach to the children in this school. So any unknown stranger giving you chocolate, you are taught. You only would have taught thousands and thousands of children. Say, no, thank you. But we, even elders, we fall victim for such kind of free offer. The other advice is, near the airport or elsewhere, they give you some keychain or various other trinkets free. If somebody is coming and offering you such kind of trinkets, kindly do not take it. Even ambassadors of various countries in G20, you know, G20 meeting where the great countries meet, they were given a USB as free as a keychain. Then they put it in their laptops. They were all compromised by the US or USSR or any other country which hosted such kind of things. So if ambassadors are falling victim to such things, you and me are not exempted. Do not accept anything free. In this area, you are being trapped by people continuously giving free things to you. There is no free lunch at all in life. And when we talked about the Roti Bank scheme, madam, your scheme, I wanted to tell people who are listening that we have served 1.6 million people in the last few days. That is the corona period, March 26 onwards. Yes. 1.6 million people we have served for. And we are looking forward to the next 6 months at the same rate. That is 30,000 meals a day I'm going to serve for the next 6 months. That's our commitment. Thank you, ma'am.
I'm sure that will be possible, sir. May the rotis grow and grow and more children are fed. That is my prayer, sincere prayer. Brijesh, on to you.
Yes. Thank you so much, ma'am, for the wonderful question. And thank you so much for having sir on the platform. It was really an eye-opener today. And thank you for Singhania Schools for partnering with the Roti Bank program. As they say, service to man is service to God. So, sir, you're really, really doing a wonderful job. And we thank you for that. And believe me, sir, our comment box is flooded with questions today. Parents are very, very curious about the information that you brought to the fore today. So I would like to start off with a few questions. One question, ma'am, has already spoken about the Wi-Fi. So I move to the next question. Children are very much into online gaming nowadays, sir, right? And many a time, these gaming platforms usually encourage children to download these coins, buy certain things. How risky are these gaming platforms, sir? Can you throw a bit of more light on this?
You know, any gaming in life, you are on a slippery wicket. Online games, there are companies which are legal, but then Supreme Court order is giving them the empowerment, saying that this game of skill is not gambling. Game, it is called game of skill. For example, card games. They are considered right. Game of skill, where your luck and chance is not depending upon, the reward is not depending upon luck. So on that Supreme Court order, these online gaming companies are thriving. But then right. It becomes a habit. You get addicted. You've been shown Mahabharat and Ramayana daily in the evening in our TV. What happens there in Mahabharat? The man, he wagers his brother's wife, the country and the crown and whatnot. So no online gaming platform is free of risk. In my opinion, they are addictive. It is as good as taking brown sugar, cocaine, or smoking cigarettes, tobacco addiction, and things like that. In my opinion, you can read a book, write a book, sing a song, dance to your tune. You can do so many other productive things rather than getting into online gaming. It is addictive. You will lose money. My opinion as a police officer is, there is not a single one who has gained any any considerable amount of money by doing online gaming or going to race course, you know, betting on horses and things like that. My advice is work hard, be honest, and what is in your pocket is yours. What is in somebody else's pocket can never come to your pocket.
Absolutely, sir. That was very well put. Thank you so much for that answer, sir. We move to the next question. Online chatting has become a norm for the youngsters today, you know. They go to various chat rooms. So according to you, sir, what are the three most important precautions that they should take when they enter a chat room? Three very critical checkpoints.
I actually wanted to put up a slide because I was a little hesitant to bring examples. I was not putting that slide. You know, in Mumbai, one of the most famous schools, they had a chat group. Yes. And they went into absolute crime. They were small children, so they maybe they were let off. They are belonging to very famous families and others. But then what they did was a regular crime. You know, it's a crime, cyber crime, body shaming, discussing about your fellow friends and others, girls particularly, boys. And I don't want to go into the details. People who have seen the Mumbai Mirror first page will remember.
Right.
Lo and behold, Mr. Brijesh, the same thing has happened in Delhi recently again.
Oh.
So all these elite schools have to prepare their children to be careful about these online chats. We are encouraging WhatsApp group for them so that they can engage in reading, in homework, in exchanging information for excelling. I have given a trophy for excellence in Singhania School. And madam keeps writing to me every year that this year this boy or this girl won Shivanandan Cup of Excellence. So I'm going to give one more cup on cybercrime awareness trophy. So please tell everybody that this online chatting is extremely dangerous. And young minds are uncontrollable. They've got hundreds and thousands of horsepower energy they have. So get into online. As I told you earlier, whatever you write, read, speak, or visit, that is on record. I'm Brijesh, I'm again telling you once again, whatever they do online is on record. They cannot erase it. President Nixon had indulged in that Watergate scandal. Children will not know, elders will know. Later, all of them were deleted by him. But down in the underground of White House, there was a huge supercomputer where all the deleted mails can be reconstructed. He lost his job. He was to be impeached, you know. I want everyone to go to the Google and check. President Nixon was going to be impeached. And he had to resign and go because whatever he did on the computer, he tried to delete it. But it did not happen. Somebody rebuilt it. So I'm warning all your children that do not indulge in anything which is illegal, because you can be caught and you will be embarrassed. If not anything else, reputational loss is there always. But it can amount to a crime. Online chatting has to be limited in sharing knowledge and educating others and being informed about various things. There you do not cross the Lakshman Rekha.
Wonderfully put, sir. So this is a very important lesson for all the students and the parents, that everything that you do online leaves a digital footprint and it can be traced. So very important to stay away from chatting with strangers online. God knows it may land us up in trouble sometime, right? Moving to the next question, sir, you put a very important slide about cyberbullying. So there are students across the country who are bullied by their friends or some unknown people online. Is cyberbullying officially a criminal offense, sir?
Yes, absolutely. Cyberbullying is a crime. Cyberstalking is a crime. And various things which are endangering the mental and physical stability of the children or the adults is a crime. After the famous Nirbhaya case in December 2012, stalking has become a separate offense. Pouring acid has become a separate offense. Attempting to pour acid, it is 10 years punishment and 7 years for attempting to do that. And even watching, you know, voyeurism, for example, in the mall you go there, our famous lady minister, Madam Srimati Smriti Irani in Goa, she had gone to buy some clothes. She found out a small dot in the knob of the door, and there was a camera hidden in that. She made a cry and brought the ceiling down. So please tell your children that look for hidden cameras everywhere. and look for hidden elements everywhere. Look for hidden virus everywhere, and you are vulnerable in this area. Cyber bullying is a crime. Sending offensive text all the time is crime. And ordering various Amazon material in the name of yours and you are asked to pay is a crime. All these things which you can imagine, they are all crime. And this law is evolving every day. Please beware of that. And as you rightly said, the footprint is left wide and broad and we can prosecute you. The big brother, as they say, the big brother is watching you.
Always watching. Yes, absolutely. Sir. The brother, big brother is always watching.
Yes.
Yes. Sir, now as laymen, you know, we use internet every day. We go online every day. We know certain things are right and certain things are wrong. So when we know that we have a notion that certain things are wrong, how do we restrict access to these people, sir? So if you can throw a little bit, you give wonderful slides, three slides on how do we protect ourselves. But in layman language, two or three simple things that we do to protect ourselves every day, you know, as a daily practice, if we can follow those steps, we are usually, you know, safe and sound.
You know, one thing is access to your own systems that nobody has access to you. So is your access to your emails and various other chat groups and various other things. And beware of what you are doing and see that you know you do not violate and you do not allow others to violate. For example, in an office room setup, when you want to go to the washroom, you can leave your system open, right? Then somebody who doesn't like you can do that. Earlier, you mentioned about cyberbullying and threatening and all that. It can be your next seat friend who is doing it, but you don't know. Right. For example, you, now that you asked me, voice over internet protocol, VOIP system, and WeChat, Woot, and various other things are all there, which criminals like Pujari, you know, Hemant Pujari and Ravi Pujari, they've been using it. So then they call someone to threaten and extort money. Their location is changed every minute, every second. Sometimes he's calling from South Africa, sometimes from Kenya, sometimes in one call, multiple locations are so. But you are ultimately, if you see, it is the next door neighbor or the man sitting next to you. In a student's case, the next bench man, image boy or girl can be doing that. So you have to be aware of your environment, your people, and your protective China wall should not be breached. Okay. Yeah. Now, how can a wall be breached? In all our history, if you go back and read, it was never a fort was broken open by anybody. It was always an insider who gave the key. So in our cases, in our case or your case or in a company man's case, we give the password to somebody else to operate our systems. And when we remove an employee, we do not remove his password first. Agreed. We do all other things, but we don't remove his password. Even huge companies do not do that as a drill. So they go out of the job and connect hands with some friend who is there in your system. Means a removed employee and an existing employee, together they hack the system and commit a crime. So you have to be, you know, I have detected cases like that. I've investigated cases. That company's name, I cannot tell you. It's a multi-billion dollar company. Multi-billion dollar company. But it happens. So awareness, my last slide. You have to be aware. You have to have resources. And you have to have a progressive mindset.
Right. So that was very beautifully put, sir. Access to your own computer has to be in your own hands. And you have to be in control of what you're doing online. Next question, sir. Nowadays, we have seen last few years, banks have been promoting online banking quite often. So we are getting this is a very common question, which is coming from quite a lot of parents. You put it in the chat box. How safe is online banking in that case?
You know, nothing is safe at all in this cyber world where nothing is safe at all. So in my opinion, online banking and payment has become a must. When you cannot get the house because of corona, invisible enemy, you have to buy your food, you have to buy Amazon, this one, that one, grocery.
Right.
So my advice to all of them is do online banking with a bank account with a minimum balance in that. If let us say I have saved about 25 lakhs in my life, that is the ultimate money ever I have earned. So I cannot use that account for banking online practice. I have a bank account, I have a debit card or a credit card and things like that. that is linked to a bank account, keep minimum balance there. Okay,
right.
But online fraud takes place in your case, maximum loss should be 25,000 rupees, 50,000 rupees. I want to tell all the parents who are listening to my presentation, your credit card credit level can be increased for 1 minute by you. Like you want to buy a Louis Vuitton bag, it is 3.5 lakhs of rupees. You raise your credit limit by going online system, buy that bag and bring it to your credit level back to 5,000 rupees. I hope, Brijesh, you are getting what I'm telling you.
Yes, absolutely, sir. Absolutely.
Instantly you can raise it, instantly you can reduce it, and you can take a lot of safety precautions. For example, every card, you cannot keep it openly in your wallet.
Right.
You have to put it in a rubber sheet which comes along with the company's thing, so the radio frequency message cannot be read by a reader by coming close to your body in the airport or railway station or anywhere. So, because have to be taken. Banking, online, I am telling you, it is inevitable now. So, keep minimum balance and keep your credit level of your card to the minimum. Your debit card, they can swipe until your last rupee is there in the account. What if you are at 10 crores in your account, they will swipe you off. But if you have only 10,000 rupees, if you have got only 10,000 rupees, okay, you are traveling. What if you are traveling? You can transfer from the other account to this account by banking systems.
Right.
So 10,000 rupees is over, transfer another 10,000. I'm giving only an example. It can be 10,000, 3,000, 1 lakh, 2 lakh, shock absorber. You know, how much of shock can you absorb? That much level only, keep it in the online banking account.
That's a beautiful lesson which sir has told us, that restrict the amount that is there in your banks, right? So which will help you controlling the expenses, and the surplus amount can be kept in a safe account. You were saying something more, sir.
No, I said the credit limit. Also the credit limit. You can change it every minute. For example, I'm a director in a bank called RBL, where you have this credit card. You increase the limit and decrease the limit at will. So nobody else can steal your money. For example, if my credit limit is 3 lakhs, I can bring it to 3,000 rupees and keep it there. When I want to use it, I increase it. When I don't want it, when I allow you use by mistake, you spend only 3,000 rupees per swipe. Okay?
Right.
Next question.
So thank you so much for that, sir. As I told you previously, the comment box is actually flooded with questions. But because of shortage of time, I'm going to take this the last question. I'm going to club two questions into one, sir.
But if anyone needs CDS advice or help, they can send a mail to dsiva100@gmail.com.
Oh, lovely. I hope parents have note. Sir, one more time, if you can repeat the email ID, parents can make a note. If you have any queries, you can mail it there.
All in small case, dsiva100@gmail. 100 is very well known to everybody. It is a police number. My name is dsiva100@gmail.com.
So dsiva100@gmail.com. Thank you for sharing that, sir.
You
said I'll move to the last question and combining two questions into one. This is coming from a set of parents who basically believe in old school. Technology is necessary, but some parents feel technology has more disadvantages than advantages. Were we better off earlier? And secondly, how can parents save their wards from cyber exploitation? If you can conclude with that, we'll be very thankful, sir.
I want to tell you, like the sun and the moon rising in the east and setting in the west, can you stop that? In
Not
the same
all,
way,
sir.
Can you cover the sun with a basket? So if you and me belong to the old school, we will be left behind and all others will be progressing like anything. I showed you one of the slides in 1 minute, what kind of furious activities are taking, billions of activities are taking place. So the valuation of the companies have gone to hundreds of billions of dollars.
Science
and technology cannot be changed. Yesterday, Elon Musk has sent a rocket to the Mars. You know?
To the ISS, yes.
Yeah. He's a private guy. So for example, we are used to petrol car and diesel car, but electric cars have come.
They are here to stay.
Sunlight will give you energy tomorrow. So for using electricity, they will pay you money tomorrow. Oil price has come down. So minus $37 per barrel. These are unthinkable things which has happened. So I want to tell your parents that please believe science and technology, nobody can stop. Either you are on that, you are riding the horse of the popularity and the popular science developments, or you are left behind completely. A day will come when we will not get our daily food because you are not smart enough to order online. So please beware that you have to go along with that, but you have to be completely the harness, lagam jo ghode ke upar jo baithe hain. So the lagam has to be in your hands or not somebody else's hand. That Absolutely. Is the technology. You cannot wish away the development of science and technology. You have to be going along with that, but the control has to be in your hands. For example, when you buy a car of 5 crores, Maybach, do you know that somebody else can drive behind you? They can have a mobile phone, this mobile phone.
Right, and they can hack the systems and take control.
When you are driving your car at 40 kilometers, I can drive your car at 200 kilometers.
Right.
Sitting behind in another car. Right. So beware of that. Science and technology, you cannot stop. You have to have the control with you.
Absolutely.
That answers your question. Did I leave anything?
Yes, sir. No, sir. So basically, I would like to just say that being a technology guy myself, I've been working with schools to use technology. I would like to say the biggest disadvantage of technology is not using it, you know, if at all there is. But as you very correctly said, it has to be in control. You have to be in the driving seat. You have to make sure that you are taking all the precautions. You are taking all the safety measures. And you have been so nice in answering all our questions and taking our time, sir. I would like to invite Vaijanti ma'am for a vote of thanks, sir. So Vaijanti ma'am, if you can take it forward from here.
Here's my vote of thanks. Thank you very much. I enjoyed the chat as much as others did. I wonder.
Thank you so much, sir. It was so wonderful and it was an eye-opening session. So Vaijanti ma'am, if you can take it forward.
This is to Revati madam for bringing me on board.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you so much, Sivanandan sir, for that absolutely massive eye-opening session where you had so many insights for all students and all parents. Thank you. That has been an absolute huge exercise in cyber education for all of us, which is such a need of the hour.
Thank you very much, ma'am.
To sum up, sir, all Solonians and students, thank you from the bottom of our hearts to make us a part of your noble cause of the Roti Project. Every Tuesday and Friday, with great enthusiasm and sincerity, students as well as teachers have contributed, has been an abject close from junior KG right up to all students. Thank you so much for being here today and being with us every day. Thank you, sir. And to all our viewers, all the students and all the parents listening to us, I do hope you picked up a lot of tips and got a lot of insights into how to conduct yourself. Getting smart and being smart is the way forward in life. And as a Solonian, smart. And we
I think we lost Vaijanti ma'am's connection. Sivanandan sir, you were saying something, sir.
No, I wanted to say final word that it's an excellent opportunity to interact with these Sanganiya school students. Be safe. I wanted to tell all of you, the teachers and the others and you and everyone, be safe because we are fighting an invisible enemy called Corona. Until the vaccine is discovered, we have to be very, very safe and do not take any risk by exposing yourself. Be safe and then we will meet for more chats. When you do any other interesting chat, invite me as a guest. I would like to sit and listen and learn.
That will be lovely, sir. Thank you for teaching something that we had learned in our childhood. Prevention is always, always better than cure. That was so wonderfully put with the help of so many beautiful slides, beautiful examples, and wonderful stories. Thank you, sir. So, Vaijanti ma'am, if you may take it forward.
The SESL platform, like all the viewers would agree now, the SESL platform has always brought forth speakers who contribute in some way by bringing very valuable insights to one and all in different aspects. We've had on parenting, we've had a session on stress management, we've had this session on cybersecurity,
And the upcoming one is sure to make you get that extra dose in health and fitness. So stay tuned for the 6th of June, where we will be joined by Mrs. Rujuta Divekar, a dietitian, a health and wellness expert. So stay tuned and join us yet again for another wonderful session with Ms. Rujuta Divekar on the 6th of June at 5 p.m. Until then, take very good care of yourself and be cyber smart and cyber safe. From all of us here, thank you for being here.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.